Students, today we are going to study chapter number 6 of science. The name of the chapter is Changes Around Us. Students, this is a very simple chapter and very easy to understand also. Let's start the chapter. Change is a continuous process. It is the law of nature. Changes takes place around us all the time. So, to understand these changes, let's take a look at some common changes happening around us. First is change in size. All of us born as a small baby. Then our body grows, our weight increases, our height increases, and after passing all the stages of life, we finally reach old age stage. During our entire life, our hair and nails keeps on growing. So, what kind of change is this? This is change in size. Similarly, it happens with plants and animals also. From a small seed which we sow in soil, a plant turns into a huge tree. The summers are really hot, whereas the winters are cold. What kind of change is this? This is change in temperature. In fact, change is in temperature is observed on day-to-day basis. Some days are really hot, whereas others are not. In summers, the days are quite hot, whereas the nights are cool, isn't it? All the planets of our solar system are continuously revolving around the sun. So, what kind of change is this? This is change in position. They are continuously changing their positions. Students, so during sunset or sunrise, the color of sky is somewhat like given in first picture, or some yellowish type. You can see it in the picture also, isn't it? But the sky appears to be blue during the day, and in night sky appears to be dark. So what kind of change is this which you observe on a daily basis? It is change in color. So when we put the water boiling, after some time, it starts forming vapor. So, what is happening? The liquid is changing into gaseous state. Similarly, when ice cubes melt, the solid state changes into liquid state. So, what kind of change it is? This is change in state. So, now, we want to know, can we group or classify these changes? Is there any similarity between these changes? Let's find out. Yes, we can classify changes, and they are classified as reversible and non-reversible. Non-reversible changes are also called as irreversible changes. Now let's explore reversible and non-reversible changes. First, we will study about reversible changes. So, changes that can be reversed are called the reversible changes. As the name suggests, changes that can be reversed, you can obtain the change substance in its original form. Let's take an example. We have a paper here, and we make a paper boat out of it. Paper was the original substance, and we made a paper boat out of it. So this paper boat is the changed substance. Okay, now I want my original substance back, means I want my paper back. So can I get my paper back? Yes, I can. I just have to unfold this paper boat, and I will get my paper back. Yes, it will be little crushed, but I will get my paper back. So these kind of changes where the change can be reversed and you get back the original substance are known as reversible changes. Okay, let's take one more example. Again we have a paper and we just crushed it up as seen in the figure. But now we want this paper back. Can we get it back? Yes, we can. Again, we just have to unfold the paper and we will get the paper back. Okay, so you get the original substance back. So again, this is reversible change. This change can be reversed. Okay, now let's talk about the irreversible change. Now, what is irreversible change? The changes that cannot be reversed are called irreversible changes. Irreversible changes are opposite of reversible changes. So, changes that cannot be reversed and you cannot get back the original substance. Also, irreversible changes are permanent changes. As you cannot get back the original substance, you cannot just reverse this change. So these kind of changes are known as irreversible changes. Now look at some examples. Again we have a paper here from which we made paper boat, but now we just put that paper on fire. What happens then? Yeah, paper burns and a new substance formed called ash and smoke. Burning of paper produces smoke. So now, can I get back my paper back or can I get back the original substance? Obviously, no. I cannot get my paper back as I just burnt it. So now I believe you have understood the difference between reversible and irreversible changes. So, let's have a quick look of reversible and irreversible change. What are reversible changes? Reversible changes are the changes which can be reversed. And irreversible changes are the changes which cannot be reversed. Okay? Let's move forward. Now we will see some more examples of reversible and irreversible changes. So first is melting. So let's take an ice cream on a hot summer day. My ice cream has started melting and I want my ice cream back in its original state. Can I get it back? Yes, I can. I just have to freeze this ice cream again. I will have to put this ice cream again in the fridge and I will get it back into its original state. So this is a reversible change. Let's move forward. Now look what I did. So we made chapatis out of dough. Now I want to get back the dough. Can I get it back? I have already made the chapatis and now I want the dough back in its original state. So can I get it back? Obviously no. So this is an irreversible change. You cannot get back the original substance. Let's see next example. Now we started inflating balloons for a party. But now the party is over and we want to save some balloons for the next year. So can we get back the original substance, the original balloons, the non-inflated one with which we started? Yes, we can. You just have to let the air escape out of the balloons and you will get back the original ones, isn't it? So, this is a reversible change. Let's see one more example. Now, I purchased a pencil and an eraser, but after using it for some days, you know it, get shorter and my eraser also get smaller. Now I want the original pencil and eraser back. Can I get it back? Of course not. So this is a irreversible change. As I cannot get back my pencil and eraser in its original state. So what do you think? What kind of change is freezing? The water has freezed into ice cubes. Can we get back the original water? Yes, we can. You just have to take it out of the fridge and keep it at normal temperature and you will get back the water again. So it is a reversible change. Now, we make juice out of the oranges. So once the process is done, so can I get back the oranges again? No, I cannot get my oranges back. So it is an irreversible change. Similarly, if we made curd out of the milk, can we get back the milk? No, it is also a irreversible change, isn't it? Can we get back again milk out of the curd? No, never. Curd never changes into milk. So it is also an irreversible change. Okay. Now we have mixed sugar in water. Now we want to get back the sugar. Can we get it back? Just think about it once. We have learned this in chapter 5 also in separation of substances. Yes, we can get back the sugar through evaporation process. We learned this now. So this is a reversible change. Next is cooking. So now you have made a food item out of these ingredients. So after making the food item, can you get back the ingredients? No, we cannot get back the ingredients. So this is also an irreversible change. Now here we took some dough and made some dough balls and started rolling chapati on this chakla with the help of belan. But we didn't like the shape of chapati we made. So we want the dough balls back. Can we get it back? Yes, we can get it back because we have not made chapati as of now. We have just rolled the dough. So we can get back the dough balls. So this is a reversible change. Next is burning of agarbatti. Children, when you light an agarbatti, it produces ash and gases. So can you get back the agarbatti again in its original form? No, never. So it is an irreversible change. Once the agarbatti burns, we can't back it again at its original state. So it is an irreversible change. Now what do you think about this? Ripening of fruit is reversible or non-reversible change? Can you get back the original raw fruit when the fruit has ripened? No, it is not possible to get again the raw fruit in its original state. So it is an irreversible change. So now we have looked at number of examples of reversible and irreversible change. So now I believe that you have completely understood what a reversible change and what an irreversible change is. Now our next topic is expansion and contraction. So let's start the topic. When an object is heated, it increases in size or it expands. and this is called an expansion. So when the same object is cooled, it will decrease in size, and this is called contraction. Means when you heat an object, it will increase in size. It expands its size. So this is called an expansion. And when the same object cools down, the size decreases, and this is called contraction. So now we know that expansion occurs on heating and contraction occurs on cooling. Okay. I know you must be wondering that we were studying about reversible and irreversible changes, and all of a sudden we started studying about expansion and contraction. We have a reason behind it. What is the reason? Because expansion on heating is a reversible change. As we have already studied, when the temperature is decreased, the object automatically contracts. Contraction happens. So that means expansion is a reversible change. Now we will look at some examples where expansion and contraction are used in everyday life. So here we have some soil digging tools. These are used in agriculture for digging the soil. So this iron plate and the handle, both are manufactured separately, and later on they are joined to make these tools. So now we will see that how expansion and contraction are used in fixing this iron blade and the handle. Let's see how iron blade is fixed with the wooden handle. If you see, the ring present in iron blade is made slightly smaller in size than wooden handle. So when we want to fix the handle, we have to heat the iron ring. The iron ring is heated, and on heating, ring expands. As we already studied that on heating, the substance expands. It increases in size. Now handle fits easily in ring, and when the rings cool down, it contracts and fits tightly onto the handle. This is how the iron blade is fixed with the wooden handle. Let's move forward. Now see, the wooden wheels of cart have metal rim around them. We will now see how this rim is fixed on wooden wheel. Metal rim is made slightly smaller than wooden wheel, and on heating, rim expands and easily fits into wheel. Then we pour cold water over rim, due to which rim contracts, and then rim fits tightly on wheel. So this is how the wooden wheels of cart have metal rim around them, and this is how rim is fixed on wooden wheel. So let's move forward. Now we have studied about changes, reversible changes, irreversible changes. Also we have seen many examples, right? So can you now tell me how we can bring change in a substance? Let's take a look. We can bring change in a substance by applying force, by heating, or by changing in temperature, by mixing it with some other substances, or by applying pressure on it. Okay. So I hope that you have completely understood the chapter. So here I'm concluding the chapter, and if you have any doubt or any query regarding this chapter, please feel free to ask in interactive session. Be ready with your pencil, pen, book, notebook, everything in your interactive session. Till then, stay home, stay safe. Bye-bye. Take care.